De antemano me disculpo porque a Tigo se le ha dado por no trabajar este día, entonces estoy compartiendo datos de mi teléfono. Yo espero que me aguante la hora de clases. Ok. We are going to start the class. Welcome to everyone. Welcome, Alessandro.
Hi.
Welcome, Dani.
Hi.
Welcome, Naomi.
Hi.
Ok, so. A los demás ya los había saludado, no me agregué que no los quiero saludar, ¿verdad? Ok, so, before to continue with the new topic, new evaluation, new dynamics, we are going to have a quiz. The quiz is related with the present perfect and the past simple. Quiero que, por favor, cuando vayamos a dar la respuesta, me activen micrófonos. Vamos a hacer un pequeño quiz en grupo. So, are you ready? Yes.
Yes, teacher.
Excellent. Wow. Con esa, yes. ¿Cómo se dice?
Yes, entusiasmo.
Con ese entusiasmo. Ok, solo que ingrese Israel y comienzo. Espero que se apure. Viene. Rachel, vi que tenías problemas para ingresar. No sé si estarás teniendo el mismo problema que yo.
Con el Inter creo que está fallando.
Sí, ¿tu Inter es Tigo?
No, es Claro, pero se me iba la señal.
No, a mí me pasó en la clase de tu hermana que al final, faltando 15, se me fue totalmente. Ok, we are going to do the quiz. Please pay attention. Activemos micrófonos cuando sea necesario para que me den sus respuestas.
In this video, you will try to complete each of the following 18 sentences with the correct word or words.
Vamos a conjugar dos, el simple past y el present perfect. El simple past ya lo vimos y el present perfect fue el que vimos la semana pasada. Question number one. Israel, ¿me ayuda a leer, por favor? Thank you.
Did you eat breakfast this morning?
Okay, esto está en simple past. ¿Cuál sería el verbo correcto? Obviamente, cuando ya tenemos un auxiliar en pasado, el siguiente verbo cae normal. Entonces, estudiantes, activen micrófonos. Eat, ate o eaten.
Eat.
Sí. 3, 2, 1.
Did you eat breakfast this morning?
Did you eat? ¿Desayunaste esta mañana? Teacher, ¿y por qué no es ate? Porque como le he explicado antes, como ya tengo el auxiliar en pasado, el siguiente verbo cae normal. Did you eat breakfast this morning? Number two. Alessandro, can you please help me to read? Where?
You last Thursday.
Okay. Estudiantes, are, where, or been?
Are.
Where.
¿A dónde estuviste el jueves pasado?
Where.
Okay, let's see. And the correct answer is where. Simple past. Where were you last Thursday? Number three, can you please, Danny, thank you.
I haven't did my homework yet.
Okay, aquí ya tenemos en este caso un present perfect. Do, did, or don't?
Don't.
Okay, let's see.
I haven't done my homework yet.
Thank you. Number four, can you please, Kevin, thank you.
Did your friends arrive on time yesterday?
Okay, let's see. Do, well, he already mentioned the answer, but do, did, or have? Do. Okay, let's see.
Oh.
The correct answer is did. ¿Llegaron a tiempo tus amigos ayer? Number five, Naomi, thank you.
Have you ever drank Jerry Coke?
Coke, okay. Drink, drunk or drunk? Mm-hmm. What is the answer? Mari, Israel, drunk. Rachel, opinions? Danny?
Drunk, drunk.
Okay, no. Let's see. Have you ever
drunk? Have you ever drunk cherry
drunk. Coke? Present perfect. Drunk. ¿Ya has bebido la soda de cherry, el sabor cherry? Drunk. Present perfect. Thank you. Let's see. Number six, Carlita.
Stayed Kelly late for work last Monday.
Has, was, or where?
Was.
Was.
Okay, let's see. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Was Kelly late for work?
Simple
was.
Pass.
Monday.
Was late for simple work pass. Last Monday. Was. Number seven, was. Can you please, Mari?
In I space in the ocean science, I was a child.
Don't swim, didn't swim, or haven't swum?
Don't
O sea, yo no he nadado en el océano desde que era un niño.
Didn't swim.
Let's see. Three. And the correct answer.
I haven't swum in the ocean since I was a child.
I haven't swum. Number eight, can you please, Vero?
Have you met Susan? Yes, I have. Met.
Have you met Susan? I have met. Sí, ya la conocí. Number nine, can you please, Mari, thank you.
We have lived here a space a year.
Ooh, we have lived here from since or for?
For a year.
Since
we have.
I.
Mm-hmm.
We have lived here for a year.
Okay, let's see. 3, 2, 1. We have lived here for a year. Hemos vivido aquí por un año. Number 10, can you please, Danny?
Has your brother spaced at work?
Has your brother read?
Read.
Ojo, ya tenemos has.
Okay.
Read.
Esa puede ser una ha, okay. Has your brother
read.
Entonces, si es present perfect, sería read. Reads or has read?
Read.
Let's see.
Read porque no es tercera persona.
Pero como es present perfect, ¿ha leído tu hermano este libro? Ojo, aquí está el verbo read, leer. Pero como es present perfect, ¿ha leído tu hermano? Has your brother read? ¿Ha leído tu hermano ese libro? Read that book. 11, can you please, Alessandro, thank you.
Did he have a good time? Yes, he spaced.
The correct answer, did he have a good time? Yes, he did. Oh, yes, he have.
He did.
Yes, let's see. Yes, he did. ¿Por qué? Porque la pregunta comienza con el auxiliar did. Entonces, por ende, tiene que finalizar en este caso la respuesta con did. La regla aquí, o mejor dicho, la pauta es dependiendo de con qué auxiliar comienza la pregunta.
A good time?
Yes, he did.
Number 12, can you please, Kevin?
I have never spaced in an airplane. I'm afraid to fly.
I have never flew or flown. Este es present perfect. Yo nunca he volado en un avión. Me da miedo volar. Ok, let's see. Aquí estamos usando el past participle. Past participle. Este es simple present, fly. Simple past, flew. Past participle, flown. I have never,
flown in an airplane. I'm afraid to fly.
Thirteen. Stays. Can you please, Israel?
Stays.
Ese es un nombre.
Stays. Live an hour ago.
Stacy, yo creo que es Stacy. Tuvo que ir hace una hora. Has left. Let's see. Stacy se tuvo que ir hace una hora.
Left
an hour ago. 14, Kevin, thank you.
Have you eaten dinner yet?
¿Ya cenaste? ¿O aún no has cenado? Have you eaten dinner yet? Or have you had dinner yet? Let's see. Present perfect. Carlita, 15, please.
He spaced away for over a year.
He has been a waiter for over a year. Él ha sido camarero más o menos desde hace un año.
Has been.
Let's see, is been or has been. Simple present, simple past, or past participle.
He has been a waiter for over a year.
Excellent. Has been. 16. Can you please? Thank you, Mari.
Bill Hemingway novels.
Ese es un nombre. Hemingway.
Novels.
Right? Wrote or writing?
Right.
Okay, let's see.
Did Hemingway write novels?
Write novels. Excellent. Can you please, Naomi?
Yes.
They haven't finished the space day.
Did, had, or have? Simple past or present perfect?
Have.
Let's see.
They haven't finished, have they?
Excellent, thank you. 18, can you please, Alessandro?
Yeah.
Can you please help me to read? Thank you.
Have I missing anything? No, you space.
No, you didn't. No, you aren't. No, you haven't.
Haven't.
Let's see.
Have I missed anything? No, you haven't.
No, you haven't. So, I have a question. Can you please, Kevin, turn on your audio? Everybody, yes. Turn off the audios. I'm going to turn off the, thank you. Okay. Yes, Kevin, please turn on your audio. Y se prepara Dani. Kevin, it is confused or not? The simple past versus present perfect. It is confused or it is easy for you? Se prepara Dani.
I think that it's confused because I cannot remember well. Mm-hmm. But sometimes it's easy to see what if is present perfect or present continuous, or I don't know.
What is the most we have been study the simple present, the simple past, Kevin, the present continuous, yeah. The past continuous, and the present mm-hmm. perfect. Five yeah. topics.
Yeah.
What was the most difficult for you?
Oh, I don't know.
Simple present, simple past, present progressive, past continuous, or present perfect?
I think the past continuous, because the verbs.
Because for the past participle verbs. Carlita, ¿tenés activada la cámara, mi amor? Because for the past participle verbs. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you so much. Dani, in your opinion, the present perfect topic is easy, difficult. What's your opinion about it? Se prepara Mari.
It's a little bit confused.
Why?
Because I sometimes don't remember how it's supposed to be.
Mm-hmm. Do you have problems with the past participle verbs?
A little bit. Because I don't remember all the verbs.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Have you been studying the past participles?
A little bit, yeah.
Okay, nice. Thank you so much. Mari, what's your opinions? In this case, with you, we were studying the simple present, the simple past, the present continuous, the past continuous, and now the present perfect. So what is the most difficult topic, in your opinion? Se prepara Rachel.
For me, it's more difficult identify the past participle, but I can't use the verbs in form in the irregular form.
Yes, sometimes it's confused, right?
Yes, for me it's confused. Identify it when use the verb or the when use the time.
Uh-huh, excellent. So have you been studying on Saturday or Sunday the topic?
Yes, I try to learn to form the irregular and regular verbs.
Okay, nice. Okay, excellent. Thank you. And I'm going to finish with Rachel. Yes, what's your opinion, Rachel, about this topic?
It's confusing mm-hmm. because I don't know the verbs. Well, yes, I know the verbs, but
sí, porque yo me acuerdo que la mayoría sí a los salvadoreños. Le atinabas tú cuando estábamos estudiando mm-hmm. los past participles. I remember you were really good on that.
Yes, but in the William, the how do you say oraciones?
Sentences.
Sentences. It's difficult.
It's difficult. Okay, nice. Mm-hmm. Thank you so much. Okay, students, se prepara Ale Martínez con micrófono y Verónica. So I have 1, 2, 3, and 4 dialogues. In this case are conversations. Si ustedes se fijan, las cuatro conversaciones están en present perfect time. So we are going to practice a little bit some conversations. So, Berito, are you ready?
Yes.
Excellent. Ale Martinez, hello. Are you ready? 5, 4, 3, 2. Okay, I'm going to choose. I don't know what happened with your audio, Ale. Naomi, can you please help me turn on your audio? Thank you, Naomi. Okay. Veronica, you are going to be Rachel. Naomi, okay. You are going to be Tia. Okay. Si quieres, Ale, te dejo para la segunda vuelta. No te
sí,
preocupes. Te quieres
que estoy teniendo problemas con el Inter.
Ay, sí, mira, vieras horrible. Yo también, si aquí estoy conectada de mi celular pidiéndole a Dios que no se me vaya a caer el Inter. Ok, si quieres, intentémoslo la segunda. So, Berito, you are going to be Rachel. Naomi, you are going to be Ian. Ok, ladies, 3, 2, action.
Rachel, I hear Kate plans to quit her job next month.
Stop. Ok, Vero. Esto es para todos. Leamos de un solo, Verito. No vayamos okay. Palabra por palabra. Por ejemplo, y Rachel eres tú. Ahí no hay necesidad que menciones el nombre. Entonces, en este caso, I heard Kate plans to quit her job next month. Ok, one more time. 3, 2, 1, action.
I heard Kay plan to quit her job next month.
Excellent.
Really? Really? How long has she worked there?
She has worked 3, 4, 5 years.
That's a very long time. Why does she want to quit?
She can stand here, new manager.
Okay, thank you so much, ladies. We have some problems with some pronouns. For example, this work, the simple past, work. No es, en este caso, no es work it. Work, work. Otra palabra por acá, quick, quick. Renunciar, quick, quick. How long has she worked? Work. Acuérdense que el simple past, la pronunciación va al final de las consonantes. How long has she worked there? She has worked there for 5 years. That's a very long time. Why? Cuando es pregunta, hagamos la entonación. Why does she want to quit? She can't, la pronunciación de la T. She can't stand her new manager. Berito, Naomi, one more time, please. 3, 2, with the same conversation. 3, 2, go.
I heard Kate plans to quit her job next month.
Really? How long has she worked there?
She has worked.
Work.
She has worked there for 5 years.
That's a very long time. Why does she want to quit?
She can stand her new manager.
Her new manager. Excellent. Thank you so much, ladies. I'm going to continue with the dialogue number 2. I'm going to read by myself first. At the movie theater. Brandon, where is Marlena? The movie is about to start. Yeah, how long have we waited for her? We have waited, no es waited, it's waited. We have waited for her for 40 minutes. It feels like a 40 hours. Let me give her a call. Let me give her a call. Volunteers. Who wants to be Brandon?
Mari.
Okay, Mari and Rachel. Okay, excellent. Mari, you are going to be Brandon. Rachel, porque vi que activaste el micrófono. You are going to be thin. Okay, ladies, 3, 2, action.
Where is Marlena? The movie's about to start.
Yeah, how long have we waited for her?
We have waited for her for 40 minutes. It feels like for 40 hours.
Let me give her a call.
Perfect. Okay, excellent. Thank you. One more time, please. Volunteer for the same conversation. Volunteer, who wants to be Brandon?
Carla.
Carlita, excellent. Who wants to be Finn? Volunteers, please. Let's see.
Ale.
Thank you, Ale. Perfect. Okay, Carla, Brandon, Ale, Finn. Ladies, go.
Where is Marlena? The movie is about to start.
Yeah, how long have we waited for here?
We have waited for her for 40 minutes. It feel minutes? Like mm-hmm. minutes. It feel like 40 hours.
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 Let me give her a call.
Give. Let me give.
Let me give her a call.
Excellent. Thank you so much. I'm going to continue with the dialogue number 3. At class reunion. Dina. Taylor, is that you? Tenemos problemas con las preguntas. ¿Cómo así, teacher? Si es pregunta, dele la entonación de pregunta. No me lea, is that you? No. Is that you? Taylor, is that you? I haven't seen you for a long time. Hello, Dina. What a small world. World. Haga la pronunciación. Hello, Dina. What a small world. I know. How long has it been since we graduate? No es graduated, es graduate. Pasado. Graduate. I know. How long has it been since we graduated? We graduated high school in 2006. Podemos decir 2006 o podemos decir 26. En este caso, 2006. So, it has been over 10 years. Esta palabra no es G, no es de G, de ya, ye, ye, yo, yo. Es con... It has been over 10 years, como y, como que me como la Y, years. So it has been over 10 years since we last met. Dina, now I feel super old, but it's good to see you. We should catch up. We should catch up. Okay, I'm going to choose by myself. Let's see. Can you please? Danny, turn on your audio. Alessandro, turn on your audio. Okay. Danny, you are going to be Dina. Alessandro, you are going to be Taylor. Okay, 3, 2, action.
Taylor, is that you? I haven't seen you for a long time.
Hello, Dina. What a small world.
I know. How long has it been since we graduated?
We graduated high school in
2006.
Thank you. 2006. So it has been over 10 years since we last met.
Now I feel super old, but it's good to see you. We should catch up.
We should catch up. Thank you. Danny, can you please help me to choose one student? Choose one.
Mari.
Mari, thank you. Alessandro, choose one student, please.
Rachel.
Okay, Rachel, one more time. Thank you. Okay. Mari, you are going to be Dina. Rachel, you are going to be Taylor. Please. Remember to give the intonation if when a question is. Thank you, ladies. 3, 2, action.
Taylor, is that you? I haven't seen you for a long time.
Hello, Dina. What a small world.
I know. How long has it been since we graduated?
We graduated high school in 2006. So it has been over 10 years since we last met.
Now I feel super old, but it's good to see you. We should catch up.
Thank you. Mari, choose one student.
La lengua se me trabó cuando al unir. We graduate.
Okay. Don't worry about it. Thank you. Can you please, Mari, choose one student? Thank you.
Neri.
Aunque Neri, no sé, Neri, si ya está.
Okay.
Es que Neri está enfermita, por eso no la he hecho participar.
No hay problema. Noé.
Ok, Israel, thank you. And Rachel, choose one, please.
Naomi.
Naomi, excellent, thank you. La misma conversación. Can you please, okay, Israel, you are going to be Dina. Naomi, you are going to be Taylor. Okay, 3, 2, action.
Taylor, is that you? I haven't seen you for a long time.
Thank you, Naomi. You are going to be Taylor. Five, four, three. Oh my God, what happened with you, Naomi? You have problems with your audio? Okay, thank you so much. Kevin, can you please give a help? Thank you. You're going to be Taylor. Thank you, Kevin. Okay, from the beginning, desde el inicio. Thank you, Israel.
Okay. Taylor, I am. Yes.
Yes.
Taylor, Dina, I am. Okay.
Yes, Taylor. Yes. Okay, you're Dina. Yes, okay. Continue, please.
Taylor, is that you? I haven't seen you for a long time.
Hello, Dina. What a smart world.
I know. How long has it been since we graduated?
We graduated high school in 2006. So it has been over 10 years since we last met.
Now I feel super old, but it's good to see you. We should catch up.
Thank you. Kevin, help me to choose the last couple, please. Choose one student quickly.
I'm Danny.
Danny, thank you. Israel, choose one student, please.
Alessandro,
okay, thank you.
Okay.
The brothers, that's okay. Dialogue number 4, in the mountains. Okay, say Paul, it feels so good to go hiking in the morning. I haven't gone hiking for a long time. Agree, the air is so fresh. I'm getting hungry. How long have we been here? Me too. We have been here since 7 a.m. My stomach is grumbling. What? It has been 4 hours since we came here? Let's go grab a bite. Okay, Alessandro, you are going to be Paul. And I'm going to finish with you, Danny. You are going to be Tara. Esta es la última dinámica con ustedes dos. Okay, please go.
It feels so good to the hiking in the morning. I have gone hiking for a long time.
I agree. The air is so fresh.
I get hungry. How long have we been here?
Me too. We have been here since 7 a.m. My stomach is grumbling.
What? It has been 4 hours since we come here. let's go grab a bite.
And grab a bite. Thank you. Hey, this one, let's see. This one, este verbo. Hiking. La correcta pronunciación. Hiking. Hiking. And another one, this one. My stomach is grumbling. Grumbling. Hey, what is grumbling? Any idea, students? My stomach is grumbling.
¿Qué revolvió?
¿Perdón?
¿Qué se, como que se revolvió el estómago?
Dice.
O gruñe el estómago. Como
de hambre, que... ajá, exacto. Ajá. Como, hey, miren, el estómago está rugiendo, o sea, rugiendo de hambre, pues que, o sea, cuando nuestro estómago pide comida, que verdaderamente no hemos comido nada, hace un ruido algo extraño. Entonces, eso es grumbling. So, en equation, students, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Vamos con lo que a mí me encanta, que es la conversación. Tengo 11 questions. Todas están en present perfect. En este caso, vamos a aprender a contestar en el tiempo presente perfecto. So, I need a volunteer, please. Solamente que me ayude a ir leyendo las preguntas. Volunteer, 5, 4, 3. Thank you, Rachel. Ok, question number one. Vayan preparándose con sus respuestas, please. Rachel, question one.
How long have you studied English?
¿Desde hace cuánto tiempo estudias inglés? Next.
How long have you had a cell phone?
¿Desde hace cuánto tiempo tienes celular? Next.
How long have you had an email address?
¿Desde hace cuánto tiempo tienes un correo electrónico?
How long have you been a student? Had a job.
Aquí pueden ser dos preguntas. ¿Desde hace cuánto eres estudiante? Y para los que ya no somos estudiantes, ¿desde hace cuánto trabajas?
How long have you been married? How long have you been single?
Excelente. Aquí tenemos dos preguntas. ¿Desde hace cuánto estás casado? Y para los que son solteros, ¿desde hace cuánto estás soltero o soltera?
How long have you lived in your house? How long have you lived in your house? In your apartment.
Apartment. ¿Desde hace cuánto vives en tu casa? ¿Desde hace cuánto vives en tu apartamento?
How long have you lived in this country?
¿Desde hace cuánto vives en este país?
How long have you lived in this city?
¿Desde hace cuánto tiempo vives en esta ciudad?
How long have you known me?
¿Desde hace cuánto me conoces?
How long have you known how to use a computer?
¿Desde hace cuánto tiempo sabes cómo se usa una computadora?
How long have you liked your favorite TV show?
¿Desde hace cuánto tiempo te gusta ese programa de televisión? ¿O ha sido ese tu programa de televisión? Ok. Hay una clave para contestar cada una de las preguntas. Si usted se fija, todas tienen en común el qué. Quiero ver quién ha logrado identificar.
El have.
El have. Excelente. Y de ahí, todas tienen algo en común, que son los verbos en past participle. Por ejemplo, studied, had, been, lived, known, otra vez, like. Entonces, vamos a ver, necesito un voluntario que me haga las preguntas a mí. Ojo, no voy a dictar, solo quiero que tenga más o menos una idea de cómo las puede contestar. Volunteer, please.
Mari.
Thank you so much, Mari. Mari, uy, por ahí escuché otra vocecita. ¿Quién era? ¿Quién era la otra vocecita? No one? Okay, Mari, please, question one.
How long have you studied English?
Voy a contestar utilizando los mismos verbos porque no tengo que andar inventando. ¿What? ¿Desde hace cuánto estudias inglés? I have studied English y digamos que tiene usted 4 meses. I have studied English for 4 months. La diferencia entre four, que es por, y four, que es 4, es la pronunciación. Four con O, four. Y con OU, 4. So, I have studied for 4 months. Next.
How long have you had a cell phone?
I have had my cell phone for 3 years. Estoy inventando.
How long have you had an email address?
Ooh, I have had my, estoy hablando de mí, my email address, ooh, since 2011, no, 2008.
How long have you been a student or had a job?
Como yo soy estudiante, teacher, entonces yo voy a responder, ¿desde hace cuánto eres estudiante? Uy, teacher, I have been a student for all my life, toda mi vida, teacher, porque tengo 15 años y desde que estoy chiquito estoy estudiando. So, I have been a student for all my life. En este caso, ¿desde hace cuánto trabajas o desde hace cuánto tienes un empleo? I have had a job for 10 years, 10 años, o sea, desde hace 10 años tengo un empleo. I have had a job for 10 years. Next.
How long have you been married or single?
Supongamos que yo estuviera casada. I have been married for 5 years. I have been single for 5 years too. Desde hace 5 años, yo estoy soltera. Desde hace 5 años, yo estoy casada. Continue.
How long have you lived in your house or apartment?
I have lived in my house since 2001. Desde 2001 vivo en esta casa. I have lived in my house or in this house since 2011. Desde el año 2011. Continue.
How long have you lived in this country?
I have lived in El Salvador for all my life.
How long have you lived in this city?
I have lived in San Salvador for all my life too.
How long have you known me?
Supongamos en ese caso Mari, ¿desde hace cuánto me conozco yo a Mari? Okay. I have you known about 1 year ago. Desde hace un año. Teacher, pero si la conozco desde hace 5 años, about 5 years ago. Hace 5 años.
Teacher.
Antes. Yes.
Es una consulta para la, bueno, en este caso esta que acabo de responder sería, have you known o have known you? Porque está diciendo que la conoce.
¿Desde hace cuánto? ¿Desde hace cuánto me conoces?
No, por eso, pero ya la respuesta.
Ah, la respuesta.
Sería, sería I have known you or have you known?
I have known you. Se pueden las dos. La verdad que se pueden las dos. Yes?
Okay.
Okay. Sí, sí. Okay, thank you. So, teacher, si la conozco desde hace un año, 1 year ago. Teacher, si la conozco desde hace 3 meses, 3 months ago. Ese ago es pasado. Teacher, si la conozco desde hace 6 meses, 6 months ago. Teacher, esta es la última. Teacher, si la conozco desde hace 10 años, 10 years ago. Ok, continue. Thank you, Mari.
How long have you know how to use a computer?
Oh, my God. In my opinion, I have no how to use a computer. Let's see. Since my high school. Desde mi bachillerato. Since my high school. Yes.
How long have you liked your favorite TV show?
I remember I have liked my TV show since, let's see. Well, I don't have favorite TV show, but I'm going to invent. Since 2 years ago. 2 years ago. Okay. So, who's ready? Who wants to participate first? Volunteer. 5, 4,
teacher.
Okay, Vero, thank you. In this case, ¿Quién me ayuda a hacerle las preguntas a Berito? Así voy a hacer, voy a ir haciendo parejas. Volunteer, please. Who wants to read the questions? Fine. Okay. Yes, Rachel? Okay, excellent. Thank you. Okay, can you please, Rachel, ask the questions to Veronica? Thank you. Go.
How long have you studied English?
I have studied English for 4 months.
Next.
How long have you had a cell phone?
I have had my cell phone for 3 years.
Next.
How long have you had an email address?
My address is 10 years.
Next.
How long have you been a student or had a job?
I have had a job
2010, since 2010. Next.
How long have you been married or single?
I have been single for 10 years.
10 years. Okay, next.
How long have you lived in your house or apartment?
I have lived my house 20 years.
Okay.
How long?
Stop. Now we are going to switch. Berito, ahora las preguntas del otro lado se las harás tú a Rachel.
Okay.
Comenzamos con, how long have you lived in this country? Okay, Rachel, please be ready. Okay, Berito, go.
How long have you lived in this country?
I have lived in El Salvador all my life.
How long have you lived in this city?
I have lived in the San Salvador city all my life. Same.
How long have you known me?
I have known about 6 months.
How long have you known how to use a computer?
I have known use a computer since first grade.
How long have you your favorite TV show?
One year ago.
Thank you so much, ladies. If you want, you can leave the class, or if you want, you can continue in class. I need 2 volunteers, please. Who wants to be in the next one? Thank you. Volunteer 5.
Mari.
Thank you, Mari.
Yes. Se le oye así como... Ay, no sé qué. Así se le escucha como a lo largo el sonido.
Okay. I'm so sorry for that. And now? Is better?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you so much. Volunteers, Mari, number 1. Mari. Number 2? Number 2, 5, 4, 3, to. Oh my goodness, we don't have volunteers.
Me.
Okay.
Me.
Okay, thank you, Alessandro. Okay, Alessandro, can you please ask the first questions to Mari? Las primeras preguntas. Thank you. Go.
How long have you studied English?
I have studied English for 4 months.
Right.
Next.
How long have you had a cell phone?
I have had my cell phone 3 years ago.
How long have you had an email address?
Wow, I have had my email address 20 years ago.
Oh, yeah.
Wow.
How long have you been a student? Had a job?
I have been a job 3 months ago.
Right. How long have you been married or single?
Marriage.
Marriage.
I have been married for 4 years.
Next. How long have you lived in your house or apartment?
I have lived in my house for in San Salvador 32 years ago. For now, 4 months ago.
Excellent, perfect. Now switch, Mari. Can you please continue with the next questions to Alessandro? Thank you.
Alessandro, how long have you studied English?
No. The second part. How long have you lived in this country?
Okay.
Thank you.
How long have you lived in this country?
Well, all my life.
I have lived all my life. Present perfect. One more time, Mari, right. Again.
Sorry.
Okay. Alessandro, how long have you lived in this country?
I live in this country all my life.
Present perfect. I have lived. No, I live. Sí, está bien. O sea, yo vivo aquí. Ok, pero quiero que utilicemos el present perfect. I have lived in this country for all my life. One more time, Mari, please.
How long have you lived in this country?
I live. Así.
I have lived.
I have lived in this country all my life.
Excellent. Next.
How long have you lived in this city?
Again, I live in this city all my life.
I have lived, present perfect. I have lived. In this city?
Me confundo al decirlo. I have lived in this city all my life.
Excellent, next.
How long have you known me?
Who are you?
In bed, Alessandro, I have known you for 1 month ago. That's your mess, for example. I have known you for 1 month ago.
I know you. I have known you for 2 weeks
ago. Excellent. Next.
Oh, yeah.
How long have you know how to use a computer?
I have known to use a computer maybe 5 years.
5 years ago. Okay, next.
Maybe. How long have you liked your favorite TV show?
Pero no entendí bien esta pregunta.
O sea, ¿desde hace cuánto te gusta ese programa?
Yeah.
I have liked
this TV show for 2 years.
Okay, excellent. Thank you. Thank you, students. If you want, you can continue in class or you can leave the class. I need two volunteers, please.
Carlita
and... Carlita number one, volunteer number two, please. 5, 4, 3.
Yeah.
2. Excellent. Thank you, Kevin. Okay, Carlita, can you please
the first question. This one. Thank you, Carla, for Kevin. Go.
How long have you studied English?
I have been studying English about 2 years ago.
How long have you had a cell phone?
I had my cell phone for 2 years.
How long have you had an email?
I had my email address about 7 years.
How long have you been a student? Have a job?
I have been a student from 4 years. I don't know.
How long have you been single?
Singer es cantante. Single. Aquí es soltero, single.
Single.
I have been single for about 2 months.
How long have you lived in your house?
I have been living in my house. I have lived in my house 20 years.
Okay, nice. Now we're going to switch. Continue, Kevin. Second part.
Okay. How long have you lived in this country?
I have lived all my life.
Next.
How long have you lived in this city?
I have lived in my life, all my life.
How long have you known me?
I have known you since 4 months ago, for example.
I have known you about 5 months ago.
Okay.
Okay. How long have you known how to use a computer?
I have known use the computer 1 year ago.
Mm-hmm.
And how long have you liked your favorite TV show?
Invent.
I have liked this TV show for 3 years ago. Invent.
I have lived for TV show for 5 years ago.
Okay, thank you so much, students. If you want, you can continue in class. If you want, you can leave the class. Volunteers, who's missing? Naomi? Danny, are you ready?
Sure.
Okay, Naomi and Danny. Okay, I'm going to start with Danny. Can you please ask the questions to Naomi? Thank you. Thank you, Danny. Okay, nice.
How long have you studied English?
I have studied English for 3 months.
How long have you had a cell phone?
I have had my cell phone for 2 years.
How long have you had an email address?
I have had my email for 3 years ago.
How long have you been a student or have a job?
I have been a student for all my life.
How long have you been married or single?
I have been single since all my life.
How long have you lived in your house or apartment?
I have lived in my house for 4 years.
Excellent. Thank you. Now switch. Can you please, Naomi, continue with the second part?
How long have you lived in this country?
I have lived in Salvador all my life.
Next.
How long have you lived in this city?
I have lived in San Salvador all my life too.
How long have you know me?
I have known you for a month.
How long have you know how to use a computer?
I have how to use a computer maybe 3 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
How long have you liked your favorite TV show?
I have liked my favorite TV show maybe 5 months ago.
5 months ago. Thank you so much, ladies. Nice. So just Ale Martinez, you're missing, right? Thank you, ladies. Good night. So Ale, are you ready? Good night, Alessandro. So Ale, are you ready?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, perfect. Let's see. I'm going to ask you the questions, okay? Ale.
Hey, teacher.
Bye, Naomi. Good night. Okay, Ale, how long have you studied English?
How long have you studied?
One more time, please.
Toda mi vida.
All my life. Repeat. All my life.
All my life.
Ok, ahora bien, solo que aquí tienes que contestar en presente perfecto. Sería, I have studied for all my life. Repeat.
I have studied all my life.
Ok, number two. How long have you had a cell phone?
I have 3 years ago.
Okay. How long have you had an email address?
I have had.
Mm-hmm.
Is 2 years.
2 years ago. Si queremos decir hace 2 años, tenemos que ponerle la palabra ago. 2 years ago. Next, how long have you been a student?
I have been a student.
¿Desde cuándo sos estudiante? I have been a student. ¿Desde hace cuánto tiempo sos estudiante?
All my life.
Ok, otra vez entonces. How long have you been a student?
I have been all my life.
Otra vez. I have been a student for all my life. How long have you been a student, Ale?
I have been a student for all my life.
Okay. how long have you been single?
I have been single.
Inventa.
6 years. No, 1 year.
Ah, 1 year ago. Okay. Yes. How long have you lived in your house?
I have lived in my house all my life.
All your life. Excelente. Muy bien, Ale. Thank you. Okay, ladies. Good night, Neri. Espero que se mejore. Good night, Ale. Nos vemos mañana. Good night. Bye.